So here we go, Anton Shellberg, starting it off with the serves in this best of five match. Love all. Perfect placement there. In terms of the touch from Ma Long, keeping Shellberg off the attack. Beautiful backhand inside the table. Going to be looking for that pressure wherever he can get it. Meaning near the table, near the net. Not get into the rally. Ma Long, it's so tough to win a point once the rally's open.
Red. One. All.
On a rare occasion, he'll step around the backhand side to play a forehand, leaving himself exposed. But more times than not, he finishes the point when he takes that chance.
Four.
Two. One.
A bold receive attempt there. Going for that side swiping flick. He's going to have to, though. I mean, you can understand, especially after their last encounter, the way things turned out. Right on top of the bounce, Ma Long with a lot of spin as well. Again, Wong Hao a few times on the opposite side of the table in major events with two world championships. At least, let's say, against Ma Long, where Ma Long was eliminated at the hands of his coach now.
Boom, three.
Speaking of hands, a finger-breaking serve right there, and Ma Long fearlessly goes for the attack. Who knows, maybe at the towel break, we'll have a chance to see a replay of that from every angle possible. What?
Let. Two, three.
And the long push here right to the baseline. Ma Long in control of the scoreboard. Not absolute, but enough for the time being. Back edge of the table here as Shellberg creeps back in. Pendulum serve right there. The first serve that anyone learns when they get a coach, typically speaking. And the greatest of all time, using it to perfection, still to this day. Oh, what a counter here. Shellberg behind the table takes the ball from below waist height and is able to counter for the win. It's been so long. That right there was like a DJ playing your favorite song that you haven't heard in probably 7 years. That serve right there from Shellberg had basically been retired, and he brought it back out here. Get ready. Doesn't miss by a lot. Narrow adjustment here. Subtle, but just enough. It was such an iconic serve because it was so unusual. His coach said, come up with your own serve. So we did. Kids are often told this at a young age, and then they find some success, and it sticks with them. Rocket backhand.
Five, six.
Shellberg in the lead. A lot of work to get into that backhand on the forehand side, but it pays off. It's funny, in table tennis, there's a lot of thinking going on. You have to figure, one, what will get me the best shot right now? Two, will it be enough to finish the point? And how do I balance that with staying in position? First shot, most important, but position, a high priority as well. Back to the classics. Going to be a tough way to win the point. Good receive here. Ma Long taking away any advantage there right out of the gates. It's funny, even if you yeah, the sign. There you go, right way. I was going to say, even if you don't read Chinese, Ma Long, a name that you might be familiar with, you might recognize the characters. Tied right back up here. Ma Long in the backhand to backhand exchange. A little bit of a modified shovel serve there from Anton Shelberg to get into that backhand to backhand rally.
Seven all.
Again, it doesn't have to be the most glamorous nor the most powerful shot, but if you can return it and you can place it, the backhand can be enough. Ma Long has the power when he needs it, but his timing, really accelerating with that backhand, keeping the pressure on. So just in case I misspoke earlier, Anton Shelberg actually played against Fong Jun-dong in the round of 64 at the Singapore Smash just last month. And that was where Fong Jun-dong was just next level. Very unusual shot, jammed up here. Ma Long with uncomfortable placement. For Anton Shelberg getting his, well, his feet tied up a bit there. Understandable. When you're thinking of turning the corner, someone hits you that awkwardly paced ball deep to the backhand. Perfect length from Shelberg, leaves it just inside the table and shuts down the attack, deters that forehand. Oh, Ni Hao Ban. People complimenting Ma Long here, reminding him that he's amazing. His forehand, you could argue, is the most beautiful forehand in the game. But all around, just the most complete player. That said, 9 points apiece. Anyone's game here. A lot of work for a point to the wide forehand in the opposite corner to follow. It's Anton Shelberg with a game point here against a head-scratching dictator. Doesn't miss by a lot. Fine margins this game. Serve with Ma Long against game point. Big point for Ma Long here to tie it up. Takes it to deuce. They will alternate serves now until one player has a 2-point lead. Chiquita opening side and topspin. Ma Long quite familiar with that. Interesting. W for Wang Hao. Don't know. Just a guess. More a question, really. That said, second game point for Anton Shelberg. See how many people are watching, even in the tunnelways, police officers peeking in over each other's shoulders to get a glimpse of the master class that Ma Long brings. But right now, he's down game point again. Ooh, sneaks it past. Fighting to survive in this backhand-to-backhand rally. It just goes to show you how strong Anton Shelberg's backhand is, that he's won so many points, and that he's happy to pick that fight with Ma Long. It's not always easy, but again, the wide forehand is going to be the spot where Anton Shelberg is looking to earn the opening. He's going to do that by going backhand-to-backhand where he can. Perfect length on the serve again. Third game point. Serves have been strong. Shelberg. Ma Ma Long just dries his hand. It's not a superstitious thing. A lot of people ask, why do they touch the table? Usually they do it right behind the net where the ball's unlikely to bounce, just to dry the hand. Game point, Shellberg. And that is it. Anton Shellberg takes. Either way, Ma Long serving down in games. And exploiting the line there, Ma Long. A lot of work to find that opening. How low the stance is. Shellberg here, you'd think, okay, maybe more of an opening. But as his weight starts to shift, it was clever timing from Ma Long. Good anticipation and good read.
Let one love.
Ripping backhand, recognizing an opportunity on the serve just a little bit loose. Shellberg will jump on any chance he gets. Just a question of recognizing the opportunity in time. Around the net. Beautiful coverage here. Now this serve that he went back to, I think he took notes on the first game. Watch this. Oh no, it's over the net. It was just short side of the table and shallow. Just for the record, if you're newer to table tennis, around the net is completely legal and even more so beautiful. Nice long push here. The unsung hero of the short game. I guess it's borderline as it changes from short game to the open game. Facial expression. It's just uncanny, really unbelievable how little bother it is to Ma Long, the amount of side spin that Anton Shellberg puts on this ball. Perfectly drilled into that elbow. But again, we're talking about Ma Long, so understandable. So far, half of the serves that Shellberg has played, he's won the point. Ma Long less than half of his serve. That's unusual. Remember, this is a player who's arguably one of the most dangerous servers in the game, partially because of what he's got waiting on the third ball. Also because of how subtle his serves are. A good score line here for Ma Long to change things up a bit. You can see how rapidly that ball is spinning. And you can't see that WTT logo on the back. I like this. This is something that you see from Ma Long from time to time, where he just plays it gently, keeps the ball in play. Almost like a jack in the box that's still closed. You're waiting for the moment that he's going to spring out and attack. You know it could be any moment. Speaking of springing out, Shellberg down the line here. Little view from Jorgen Persson's seat. Wow, not a bad backhand coming in. But well prepared and low. Shellberg with only the slightest bit of anticipation and enough speed to get around to counter down the line. That forehand flick, an ambitious attempt if he makes it. Everyone will applaud him for it. Hindsight, 2020. It's the idea anyway, it should be. But again, he has to take his chances, Shellberg. If he plays too cautiously, it's going to be a trouble. It's going to be problems.
3-8.
Ma Long starting to run away with the scoreboard here in game two. Again, nothing crazy with that backhand, just perfect placement. So 7 of the last 8 points before this had gone the way of Ma Long. A nice break there to change the percentages a bit for Anton Shellberg. I think the idea was right. Anton Shellberg, you could see his fishing game two of those shots come in a little bit inside the table. He's not going to be able to predict easily or counterattack. That one was solid, but this little shallow keeps it low. Now he tries to go baseline so that he can turn and counter, or even with the backhand for that matter. The crowd loving this one. The opening attack of Anton Shelberg, heavy side spin, and still Malong returns it from right off the line. Six game points now for Malong. Only needs the one, 11-4, a dominant performance after a marathon game number one. April is going to be an incredible month for table tennis. That forehand step around from Malong is dangerous. It's tough to deal with. Even with a push right to the baseline, I mean, it's one way to get into the rally with better positioning. Forehand flick comes out to play, and this time around, he puts it away. Anton Shelberg converting the point. Not a lot of wiggle room on that. Good anticipation. Wang Hao nods his head as if to say, yeah. It's okay, he played it well. Surprise, surprise. Two to that deep backhand corner. It's rare to see Ma Long surprised like that. That's off to Anton Shelberg, who's leading. Technically leading in this match overall. Is there 1-1 in games?
Let 1-2.
So compact, that backhand. Just in case you were curious, how many of the last 16 for Ma Long? 12.
3.
Fluid as can be on that backhand. It's interesting having the opportunity to meet coaches around the world. Beautiful scoop serve there, that shovel short to the forehand. Can be quite surprising for players. Oh, spraying it. The backhand quick and down the line. The reason I bring up meeting coaches in India, had a chance to talk to a coach that many of the players, just a casual guy, showed up, didn't make an announcement, wasn't there officially. And all the players seemed to know who he was and even came to him for advice. And I asked him about it, the backhand, and he said, shake my hand. I shook his hand and he said, feel my grip. It's gentle, right? I said, yeah. He said, that's how hard you should be, how tightly you should be holding the backhand.
3-4.
Wasn't a tight grip at all. For maximum whip, I mean, we saw it with Dina Meshref earlier today. The perfect demonstration of it, really. Malong down by one. Nice length on the push. Shelberg looking up at the lights for a minute as if he had maybe misjudged it.
Ball.
But again, Malong is going to do everything he can to make it uncomfortable for the opponent. He's got a long list of capabilities.
Ball. 5.
Doing everything he can to try and keep it low to the net from under the table, Anton Shelberg. Oh, the seatbelt for the finish. Anton Shelberg in a fast backhand to backhand exchange has to abbreviate the stroke and come across the chest. Deep to the corner, knows he has an opportunity to turn. That wide stance, a crucial thing in that moment. Again, it was after the ball came to his deep backhand corner that he could feel that the rally was moving back that way, that it would come back there once again to that deep corner.
Let 5-4.
the first time we've seen someone hit the ball into the bottom of the net against Ma Long's pendulum serve. Very deceptive. It's tough. Playing thousands of matches throughout your career, everybody doing something a little bit differently when they contact the ball, even with similar serves. Well, the adjustment was made on the receive. Ma Long was there to follow up and continue ahead. What, 4-2 for Anton Shelberg? The first towel break of this game. And if so, 5 of the next 6 points went to Ma Long. Beautiful rip, the step around. And one of the things that makes table tennis so fascinating to watch is the style matchup. That you can have a player who's dominant, the greatest of all time, but can be playing someone who's, say, 26 world rankings below, who can be incredibly uncomfortable for him, or even in some cases, have a winning record. These two have only played once before, according to our records, and it was Ma Long. What a chase there to get around the table, that forehand corner. A lot of footwork and reaction time required for this. From what I can see, just the World Championships in 2017. So 6 years ago, Anton Shelberg took 2 games off of Ma Long. Gave him some serious trouble. After all, that was the World Championships that Ma Long won. A very memorable match against Fan Zhendong. One of 3 in a row. 8 points apiece now, Shelberg. Tight serve. Shovel serve, deceptive rotation. And the backhand flick attempted. Human, still human. Despite the feeling that many of us table tennis fans have when we watch Ma Long play. For example, to clean up the baseline of the table with a full stroke like that takes confidence, vision, and an incredible amount of experience to really just calculate this shot. And perfectly into the crossover. Anton Shelberg has to cover the elbow there and uses the backhand to do it as one would. At least as one would with very limited time. 9 points apiece. Remind anybody of the score line in game number 1? Ma Long with the serves. And a fast long serve into the backhand. Gutsy play. Again, 80% of the serves. Half long. Ma Long goes long right to the baseline. First bounce when he hits it needs to be near his baseline for it to land near the baseline of his opponent. Game point to Ma Long. And tied up once again. A little bit role reversal. Anton Shelberg, game point in game number 1 at 10-9, but here it's deuce, so they'll alternate serves again until one player has a 2-point lead. And Ma Long sets up game points. I start to think to myself, this is only the round of 32, but there's no easy draw. Nobody's here who's not outstanding at table tennis. anyone could beat anyone on any given day. Are there odds? Of course. Are the odds in anyone's favor against Ma Long? Typically, no. Ma Long now with game point to go up 2-1. Oh, what a save! Anton Shelbert earns himself the opportunity with an incredible block. He's there. He's an incredible player. In German League, he's done so well. But the international stage hasn't really gotten the taste of Anton Shelbert that Europe has. Fun for me to sort of play out the hypotheticals here. What if so-and-so would win? What would that mean for the future of that athlete? And a win against Ma Long puts someone immediately on the map. Again, at this point in Ma Long's career, a few weeks before the Singapore smash, he had completely shut out the world number one. Oh, and burned. Turned and burned. Rotisserie there. Take a look. Cover of the middle starts to move to the backhand corner. Like a penalty kick, though, goes the wrong way. It's tough when you've got Ma Long on the other side. He sees you. You will never feel unseen against Ma Long. Just to put things into perspective, look at the stadium here. Look at the seats, how high they go. Your favorite artist. You don't know when they're going to stop touring. You must see them live. As you can imagine, a lot of my friends are table tennis fanatics.
Timeout.
And as the timeout here is called, for the first time in a long time, a side spin bothering Ma Long out here, but so many factors to consider, really, in all fairness. Heavy side spin, shallow on the table, low to the net. I mean, that's a very unusual shot from Shelbert. Ooh. Liu, a gift. He's got to try, though. I mean, the serves, when they're too long, Ma Long has won so many points, and the side spin just makes that ball carry off the net and also off the table. The amount of heat, the pace on this ball from Ma Long, gets through the first and follows up. This time, Anton Shelbert starting to move back a little bit more to the forehand side. Ma Long playing it right into the middle again. And a tight serve. Ma Long starting to run away with the game. The timeout has been called on Shelbert's side, so it's, well, now or never in many senses. Beautiful follow. Follows the serve, moves in near the net to play this as aggressively as can be. Again, looking for any opportunity to get in for that attack. And at times it might involve forcing himself to attack something that otherwise looks unattackable. For example, well, this one's attackable, but the way he plays it is so impressive. Watch him go inside out here. Moves way in, turns his body and his shoulders only just before the point of contact, but only just barely, not allowing time for Ma Long. 2-point game. Dun-dun. Dun-dun, dun-dun. An escape here. Malone coming in to recover. Just barely captures the ball. Watch how short this shot is off the top of the net. That's a bit surprising here. Shelberg looks down at the table immediately as if what was responsible for that bounce. The ball didn't go where it normally would. Malone with the cradling shot puts himself back up by three. Nice through the legs catch there to follow the point. And a timeout. Six serving eight. The pancake flip, and it doesn't bother Anton Shelberg. I call it the pancake flip because Malone comes in showing a push, defensive play with the racket open, and then quickly flips it over to attack. Not so many players do that like Malone. Nice seats, front row.
Flip. Inside and drive. Outside. Boom. Ball is inside the end line.
He's asking for clarification. Is it my toss or the point of contact?
7-8.
Fair question. I mean, the language left a little bit of ambiguity. The intention was obviously there, though. Everyone doing their best here. We'll try to toss the ball from behind the table. Perfect, sir. Now, the typical advantage of serving and tossing the ball so close to the baseline of the table is you have a wider angle and less time for the opponent to react. A lot of players even practice their serve toss just to make sure it's barely above 16 centimeters, the required height, which starts from the moment it leaves the palm of your hand, once you actually project the ball. Big point here to break away. Only 1 point in front, but if Anton Shelberg can take this, he's got two serves at 9-9 and a chance to send this to the decider. Cleaning of the table out here, Malone recognizing just a little speck here or there that could affect the bounce of the ball in a way he doesn't want. Ooh, top of the net, climbs over and stays right near the net. So the plot thickens once again, regardless of who you're rooting for. A game five could definitely be exciting for the spectator. Classic pendulum. Touched there perfectly. So Anton Shelberg here, a bit of fortune there, the perfect touch. Out of the last 8 points they've played, six of them have been to the man who needs them most, Anton Shelberg. These rallies are getting just more delicious as they come. As fast as can be, the serve perfect from the start. Anton Shelberg keeping it short enough to keep Malone passive. And Malone, one of his greatest strengths is that he can attack the ball inside the table where most can't. So if you can get him to play passive and hesitate to do that, you get the third ball. Anton Shelberg with game point.
Let 10-9.
Oh, and he does it. Squats, gets low, and burns the ball down the line. Out of reach to the wide forehand. Anton Shelberg serves on his side. That is just too fast. Hits him in the face. I mean, you could hear skin on it. It came up. After it hits anything other than the racket, that's a clear separate shot. Body there. The slow-mo replay. Anyway, it sounded like skin. Either way, point immediately over. Even just the shirt, this is a common point of contention. You'll see players hit the ball at the middle, as they often go for. and then think they've finished the point by hitting the opponent in the shirt. They'll give that signal, they'll tug on their shirt as if to say, hit you in the shirt, right? No? All good. Good start here. Anton Schellberg converting both of his serves. Interesting. Now, with all the different camera angles, I've seen things online about how you can choose different angles to watch. WTT offering spectators this option to watch from many different camera angles. Different angles are going to show you different aspects of the game at different points. You can never capture everything all at once. At least not show it all at once. A battle of wits out here as soon as that ball went below the table. Ma Long playing a soft, spinny shot, shallow on the table, and Schellberg guides it back, keeping it as low as possible, but then drilled into the body. Every point so far has been won by the server here in the decider. Oh, it is just too pretty. The bending backhand under pressure. Remember, Ma Long could argue the best forehand in the game for a handful of reasons. Obviously, Quadri Aruna with power. Ma Long with precision and versatility in ways that are really tough to do, what Anton Schellberg just did under pressure. Still, the server hasn't lost a point yet. Curse of the commentator, Ma Long breaks the pattern at 3 points apiece now with the first towel break. Hotel towel, classic. It's just efficient, really. Lighter luggage. So drying the hand out here. There's a calm right now in the face of Anton Schellberg. Subtle variation here as Ma Long brings his forehand instead of straight middle a little bit more to the forehand side of the elbow. And it's such a low, fast drive, meaning heavy topspin, but still very forward motion as opposed to that arcing loop shot that you see in some of these distant counter loop rallies. A lot of fun table tennis terminology out there. Ma Long up by 1 point now. Good pressure. This is a race to the backhand corner. You know that feeling when your opponent, you already see their next move, but it's a question of who can get there first. Ma Long serves in a way where he really wants that third ball to just be something that he can take with the forehand from that backhand corner. So Schellberg goes as wide as possible, says, get around this. So they will switch sides here now that one player has 5 points just to keep things balanced. In any match, professional level, they will switch sides in the final game possible, the decider, when one player reaches 5 points. Schellberg hasn't had that reveal that he used to do, that sort of rainbow overhead motion that we, quite frankly, hadn't seen in a long time and he brought out here. Going for the inside-out forehand. Good opportunity. Schellberg with some pressure on the backhand. Really, the quality of these rallies. Not a wink. Not blowing a kiss. Just looking and trying to think through what it's going to take. But I wouldn't put it past him to do it, Jorgen Persson. As clever as can be, one of the great brains of the game, let alone one of the outstanding players the last several decades. Six. Perfect placement there. Even still, not an easy finish. Watch what Ma Long does, how much spin. He double pumps, hesitates for a moment, scoops it up from under the table. Imagine for the fans here in China, a chance to see Malone take a title. Again, this is only the first round, round of 32. 32 players qualified to be here, on the men's and women's side. As fast as can be. From that point of view, it was a refreshing camera angle, just in the sense of what it's like to be out there on the battlefield. How fast this forehand comes out of nowhere.
5-7.
As Timo Boll would say, first shot to the middle. Get that opponent leaning off balance. Create an opportunity to exploit the corners after that. 2 points down, Shelberg with the serves. And when Malone gets control in the forehand game and gets the opponent blocking, it is so tough to stop him. You can call them the Malone fan club, or you can simply call them table tennis fans. They're almost one and the same at this point. Five, tough to be eight. One and not the other. Malone with serious momentum here. 6 of the last 8 points played. The wide eight, forehand. Now, I told you earlier about Chun Meng's injury and how she came back stronger. Malone, his only fear, injury itself, went through surgery in 2019 on his knee and came back a bit tepid, a little bit untrusting of his new body part. Understandable, you don't want to injure yourself. And at that point, his wide forehand was the one sort of Achilles heel, his most vulnerable place, but he's really closed that up quite well. Still an inkling from time to time.
Seven.
Deep to the backhand corner. Remember, both players have already pulled their lifelines. There's no one to call now. However many points more will be played in this match, this is the last game of the night, without a doubt.
Please play.
And for one of these players, it'll be the last game of their event here in Xinjiang. Clever idea, the long push out of nowhere. It was a bit of a surprise, but the follow-up, Malone adapting incredibly well to that long push on the backhand side. I think Pearson was looking up to find a replay of the point just to analyze. He's like, oh shoot, it's me. That wasn't very helpful. As a spectator, it was fun to watch, though good entertainment. 7 serving 9. Down the line once again, as confident as can be for what seemed to be quite a heavy push. We'll have a chance in slow-mo here. Perfect read of the spin, taking his chances, Anton Shelberg. He wins this point, it's anybody's match, but it'll be Malone's 2 serves to come. Either way, it's Malone's 2 serves to come.
Let 8-9.
Both players quickly not saluting the table, nothing superstitious, just drying their hands. It's nice that certain measures have been relaxed. Missed contact. It is the touch shot of Malone. And in the touch play, Anton Shelberg had a long way to come to get in for that. The hands of Malone, take a look one more time. As short as can be, it seemed like it might have scraped the net on the way over, if ever so faintly. But it is 2 match points for Malone. If he wins this match, it would be described as scary. But it's not over yet. We've seen greater comebacks. And there it is. Malone closes the door and takes care of business. The dictator has dictated once again.